another exciting day, beloved, on the Voice of Resurrection. We are studying now our path into the mystery of Jehovah Shalom. I'm so excited. Let's go to Judges chapter 6. And the children of Israel did evil in the sight of the Lord, and the Lord delivered them into the hand of Midian 7 years. Beloved, we need to study the Old Testament scriptures, to see God's patterns of judgment. It is when we do evil in the sight of the Lord, and it's not some instantaneous thing, it's usually over time, that he turns us over into the hand of the enemy. In this case, he turned them over to Midian, and it was for a perfect seven years. 7 years. And the hand of Midian prevailed against Israel. And because of the Midianites, the children of Israel made them the dens which are in the mountains and caves and strongholds. And so it was, when Israel had sown, that the Midianites came up, and the Amalekites, and the children of the east, even they came up against them. And they encamped against them, and destroyed the increase of the earth, till thou come unto Gaza, and left no sustenance for Israel, neither sheep, nor ox, nor ass. Oh, this is so painful, beloved. That's what we are going through when we are disobedient to the Lord. The enemy plunders us, and then it looks like Christianity doesn't better you. Christianity, of course, betters you. It bettered humanity. Education, medicine, enlightenment, knowledge. This Christianity, the light of the world, Jesus. The printing press, the computers, all this stuff. Civilization as we know it. For they came up with their cattle and their tents, and they came as grasshoppers for multitude. For both they and their camels were without number. And they entered into the land to destroy it. And Israel was greatly impoverished because of the Midianites. And the children of Israel cried unto the Lord. I wanted to read the entire thing so we can begin to study it didactically. I want you to know, beloved, if you see the enemy in your land, then you know the Lord is not pleased. You have to understand that. He said that the rod of the wicked, Psalm 41, shall not rest in the lot of the righteous, meaning it may visit, but it cannot stay there. By this, I know that thou favorest me, David said, because thou will not allow my enemy to triumph over me. You need to have the unleavened bread of sincerity and truth if you're going to meet Jehovah Shalom, so that you will not attribute your faith failures to God. You will not attribute anything that you are not able to overcome as the will of God, which is what religion has done. So if I pray for healing, I don't receive it, then I say, God gave me the sickness. No, beloved. God does not, like a faith preacher said years ago, he does not have sickness to give. These things came out of sin. So, Midian was in the land of Israel because God was displeased with Israel. And he turned them over to Midian 7 years. The question that we need to investigate, if you've heard some of this message on television, then hear it again. The question is, who are the Midianites? The Midianites came from a son of Abraham through Keturah. And when you look at it, beloved, that's why I heard myself saying on television, God is right. I know men sometimes may want to marry more than one woman. And I've seen people from polygamous families. These are nations by themselves. Each woman and her children is a nation. And they all have all these issues and conflicts and judgments. And I've seen some, I heard of some guy that was married to three or four wives. And then after a while, he was so afraid that one of them will poison him because they were warring against each other. All these ignorant Muslims saying that they're murdering people so they can get seven virgins in paradise. Who is promising you that foolishness? You can't even handle one on the earth. So are you going to handle seven? Jesus says that when we cross over to the other side, that we are like the angels of God. We don't get married and nobody's giving in marriage. This is false religion, beloved. Spread the word. And so when God healed Abraham, he went and married Keturah. And he had other children. I don't know how many, but I'll look it up. You know, but at death, when he saw he was close to leaving the earth, he blessed them and sent them all away from Isaac. And that's where some of their bitterness came from. How is it that all these children became fathers of nations that turned against God? The enemies of God, they all came from one man. The Bible study, the Lord said that you are blessed, and even your mistakes are blessed because they are yours. There's so much to understand, beloved. May God keep us from the chaos our decisions have created on the earth. That when we leave the earth, and when we look down from heaven, we'll not be looking in sorrow. May God strengthen you, encourage you. If you've made errors and there's chaos in your life, pronounce peace. Be still. And God will honor it and help you. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. See you tomorrow. Bye-bye.